हेलो एवरीवन, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न द टॉपिक्स नेम इज क्लासिफिकेशन एंड इट्स टाइप्स एंड सम बेसिक टर्मिनोलॉजीज इन स्टैटिस्टिक्स. लेट्स स्टार्ट विद द टॉपिक क्लासिफिकेशन एंड इट्स टाइप्स. क्लासिफिकेशन इज द प्रोसेस ऑफ मेकिंग होमोजीनियस नॉन ओवरलैपिंग ग्रुप ऑफ ऑब्जर्वेशंस अकॉर्डिंग टू देयर सिमिलैरिटीज एंड रिसेम्बल्स. Simply, the classification is nothing but the process of making homogeneous groups, but they are not overlapping, and the making the group on the basis of their similarities. For example, students in a class are classified as on sex, age, religion, height, weight, etc. Now, next is types of classification. There are four types of classification. One is geographical classification, second chronological classification, third qualitative classification, and next is quantitative classification. Let's see the types one by one. So first is geographical classification. What is mean by geographical classification? If the classification is done on the basis of area or location, such as cities, states, regions, zones, etc., called as the geographical classification. For example, area under cotton in various districts. See, here we are given area under cotton with different districts. So this classification is done on the basis of district, that means area, so called as the geographical classification. Okay, now the next is chronological classification. If the classification is done on the basis of time, such as year, month, called as the chronological classification. For example, population of India in different year. See the given data, that means classification is done on the basis of years, so called as the chronological classification. Then next, qualitative classification. If the data is classified on the basis of qualities, that means attribute type data, then such classification is called as the qualitative classification. In previous example, we already discussed that the qualitative data means can be observed, seen, judged, but can't be measured. But quantitative data means the numerical values data, which can be measured. Okay, now the next is quantitative classification. If the classification is done on the basis of numerical values, that means quantitative measurement like age, weight, price, income, production, called as the quantitative classification. See the example, daily earning in office. See the data is classification is done on the basis of numerical values, daily earning with number of person. So this is nothing but this is the quantitative classification. These are the four types of the classification: geographical, chronological, qualitative, and quantitative. This is basic terminology. So first is class. In general, what is mean by class in college? The class is nothing but the group of students. Okay, similar in statistics, what is mean by class? Class is nothing but the group of observations or the group of variable values called as the class. See the example, 10 to 20. This is nothing but the group of observation from 10 to up to 20. That means 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, up to 20. This is the group of observations, so called as the class. So this 10 to 20 called as the first class of our example. 20 to 30, that means second class, started from 20 to up to 30. Every class having the two limits, lower limit and upper limit. In example, 10 to 20, 10 is lower limit and 20 is upper limit. And in second class, 20 to 30, 20 is lower limit and 30 is upper limit. So class is nothing but the group of observations. Okay, now the next is class limits. Okay, every class having the two limits, lower limit and upper limit. Okay, the two observations which define a class is called as the class limit. In the previous example, 10 to 20, these two numbers, two observations are
define a class called as the class limits. Okay, suppose for example we are giving the lower limit is equal to 2 and upper limit is equal to 10. Then what is my class? Okay, these two numbers are used to define a class. So 2 is the lower limit and 10 is the upper limit. So this is my class. These two numbers are used to define a class, so called as the class limits. Okay, now the next is inclusive and exclusive classification. What is mean by inclusive classes and exclusive classes? See, the first inclusive classes, in this method of observation equal to upper limit is included in the same class. Simply, if upper limit of current class is not equal to lower limit of next class, then such classes is called as the inclusive classes. See the example. For example, classes we are given 10 to 20, 21 to 31, 32 to 42. Suppose I am considering first class 10 to 20. Okay, what is mean by inclusive class? If the upper limit of a current class, what is the upper limit of this class? 20. If upper limit of current class is not equal to the lower limit of next class, lower limit of next class is 21. Okay, so upper limit of current class is not equal to the lower limit of next class, then such classes is called as the inclusive classes. See, the next is, suppose I am considering second class. What is the upper limit of second class? 31. If the upper limit of current class is not equal to the lower limit of next class, then such classes is called as the inclusive classification. But the one line is, in this method, observation equal to upper limit is included in the same class. What does it mean? See, suppose the data we are given, the observations are 20, 21, 30. Okay, the classes are 10 to 20, 21 to 31, 32 to 42. Okay, if the observation, suppose what is the my first observation is 20. This observation is equal to the upper limit. Okay. So, if the observation equal to upper limit, then it is included in the same class. The first class is from 10 to 20. So, this 20 observation lies in first class. Now, the second observation is 21. So, 21 lies in second class because second class is started from 21 to 31. Now, third is 30. So, 30 lies in this class, second class, because the second class is started from 21 to 31. Okay, these are the inclusive classification. Now the next is exclusive classification. In this method, observation equal to upper limit is not included in the same class. Simply, if the upper limit of current class is equal to the lower limit of next class, then such classes is called as the exclusive classes or exclusive classification. This exclusive classification is opposite to inclusive classification. See the example. My classes are 10 to 20, 20 to 30, 30 to 40. Okay. So what is mean by exclusive class? Suppose I am considering first class. If the upper limit of current class is equal to the lower limit of next class, then such classes is called as the exclusive classes. Simply, next class, suppose I am considering second class. Upper limit of current class is equal to the lower limit of next class, then such classes is called as the exclusive classification. See, and also one line, in this method, observation equal to upper limit is not included in the same class. What does it mean? See the example. So, suppose we are given the observations 20, 21, 30. My classes are 10 to 20, 20 to 30, 30 to 40. Okay. So, in data, the first observation is 20. Okay, if the observation equal to upper limit, then it is not included in the same class, it included in the next class. Okay, in exclusive classification, if observation equal to upper limit, then it is not included in same class, it included in the next class. This is nothing but the exclusive classification. But in inclusive, if observation equal to upper limit, then it is included in the same class. Okay, now the second while observation is 21. This 21 lies in second class because the class is started from 20 to 29. 30 is not in the second class. 30 lies in the next class. This 30 is equal to upper limit, so it is not included in this class, it included in the next class. This is nothing but the exclusive classification. This is the basic difference between inclusive and exclusive classification. Now the next is open-end class. What is mean by open-end class? A class in which one of the limit is not specified, then such classes is called as the open-end class. For example, below 10, above 20. Okay, what is mean by below 10? Below 10 means 10 to less. But here the lower limit is not specified, but upper limit is specified. Upper limit is 10, but here lower limit is not specified. Similarly, in second example, above 20 means 20 to onwards. But here the upper limit is not specified, but lower limit is specified, that is 20. So in a class, if one of the limit is not specified, then such classes is called as the open-end classes. Now the next definition is class boundaries. The number up to which class can be extended, that's a class boundary. See the first, how to calculate the class boundary. Suppose we are given example 10 to 20, 21 to 31, 32 to 42. Okay, that the given classes are is in inclusive form, because here the upper limit of current class is not equal to the lower limit of next class. Okay, so how to calculate the class boundary? Take upper limit of any class. Suppose I'm considering upper limit of first class. Okay, so upper limit is 20, and take lower limit of next class. What is the lower limit of next class? Is 21. So how to find out the class boundary? Lower limit of next class and upper limit of previous class whole divided by 2, that is 21 minus 20 divided by 2, that is 1 divided by 2, that is 0.5. so this 0.5 is nothing but the class boundary, and this class boundary is used to convert inclusive classes into exclusive one. Okay, so how to convert inclusive to exclusive one? So the given classes are is in inclusive form. Okay, so what are the lower limits? 10, 21, 32. 10, 21, 32. And upper limits are 20, 31, 42. 20, 31, 42. So the for converting inclusive classes to exclusive ones, subtract class boundary from each lower limit and add class boundary in each upper limit. So subtract 0.5 in each lower limit and add 0.5 in each upper limit. So first lower limit is 10, so 10 minus 0.5, that is 9.5. 21 minus 0.5, that is 20.5. and 32 minus 0.5, that is 31.5. and now add in upper limit, so 20 plus 0.5, that is 20.5. now the next 31 plus 0.5, that is 31.5. and the last 42 plus 0.5, that is 42 plus 5.5. okay, now this is the conversion of inclusive classes into the exclusive one. See here, the upper limit is 20.5 and the lower limit of next class is 20.5, and here 31.5 and here 31.5. so the given classes are is in exclusive form. Okay, the now next point is class mark, that is mid value. The halfway point between the lower class limit and upper class limit called as the mid value or class boundary. So formula for calculating class mark or mid value is true lower limit plus true upper limit divided by 2. For finding class mark, we need the classes is in exclusive form only. Okay, so see the example, we are given the classes 10 to 20, 20 to 30. The given classes are is in exclusive form, so no need to convert. Here upper limit of current class is equal to lower limit of next class. So my example is find out the class mark of class interval 10 to 20. Okay, so formula for calculating class mark is true lower limit plus true upper limit divided by 2. What is the lower limit? 10. What is the upper limit? 20. So 10 plus 20 divided by 2, that is 15. So 15 is class mark of class interval 10 to 20. Now the next example is classes are 10 to 20, 21 to 31, 32 to 42. The given classes are is in inclusive form, because here upper limit of current class and lower limit of next class is not equal, same 31 and 32. Okay, so for finding the class mark, we need the classes is in exclusive form only. So first convert inclusive classes into exclusive one. How convert it? subtract 0.5 from each lower limit and add 0.5 in each upper limit. Subtract 10 minus 0.5, that is 9.5, add in upper limit, that is 20.5. Subtract from lower limit, so 20.5, add in upper limit, that is 31.5. Subtract from lower limit, so 31.5, and add in upper limit, so 42.5. Okay, so class mark formula is true lower limit plus true upper limit divided by 2. So find out the class mark of class interval 21 to 31. Okay, so what is true lower limit? 20.5. And what is upper limit? True upper limit 31.5. So 20.5 plus 31.5 divided by 2, that is 26. So class mark is 26. Now the next point is class width. What is the class width? The difference between true lower limit and true upper limit is called as the class width. So class width is calculated as true upper limit minus true lower limit. Okay, so see the example. We are given example 10 to 20, 20 to 30. For finding the class width, we need the classes is in exclusive form only. So the given classes is already in exclusive form, so no need to convert. Okay, so formula for calculating class width is true upper limit minus true lower limit. So here upper limit is 20 and the lower limit is 10. So 20 minus 10 is equal to 10. So this is the class width value, 10. Now see the next example. 10 to 20, 21 to 31, 32 to 42. The given classes is in inclusive form. So first convert it into exclusive. So subtract 0.5 from each lower limit and add 0.5 in each upper limit. So 31.5, then 31.5 to 42.5. Okay, so what is the formula for calculating class width? True upper limit minus true lower limit. Find out the class width of the class interval 21 to 31. What is the true lower limit? 20.5. And what is true upper limit? 31.5. So subtract 31.5 minus 20.5 is equal to 11. So class mark of the class interval 21 to 31 is 11. Now the next is frequency. The number of observations in a class called as the frequency. See the example, we are given classes 10 to 20, 20 to 30, 30 to 40 along with their frequency 2, 4, 7. What does it mean? There are two observations in a class 10 to 20. Next, there are 4 observations in a class 20 to 30. And last, there are 7 observations in a class 30 to 40. So the number of observations in a class is called as the frequency. And the table containing classes along with their frequencies, then that table is called as the frequency distribution. Okay, now the next point is less than and more than cumulative frequency. First of all, we see how to calculate less than cumulative frequency and more than cumulative frequency. We are given the frequency distribution classes along with their frequency. 10 to 20, 20 to 30, 30 to 40, 40 to 50, 50 to 60, 60 to 70, 70 to 80. Along with their frequencies 2, 4, 7, 10, 16, 8, 3. Total frequency is always denoted by capital N. Here, total of all frequencies is equal to 50. So, how to calculate LCF? LCF means less than cumulative frequency, and MCF means more than cumulative frequency. So, how to calculate LCF? Take first frequency value as it is. So, write down 2 as it is. Then add first LCF plus second frequency value, that is 2 plus 4. So 2 plus 4 is equal to 6. Now third LCF value is calculated as second LCF value plus third frequency value. So 6 plus 7, that is 13. Similarly, calculate remaining one. 13 plus 10, that is 23. 23 plus 16, that is 39. 39 plus 8, that is 47. 47 plus 3, that is 15. The total last LCF value is equal to the total frequency value, that is 50. Now calculate MCF. MCF is opposite to LCF. In LCF, take first frequency value as it is. In MCF, take last frequency value as it is, 3 as it is. So 3, then 3 plus, that is 11. 11 plus 16, that is 27. 27 plus 10, that is 37. 37 plus 7, that is 42. 44 plus 4, that is 48. 48 plus 2, that is 15. So the last MCF value, that is first MCF value, is always 50 and the last LCF value is also 50, that is equal to the total frequency. Okay, the next is less than cumulative frequency definition and more than cumulative frequency definition. The number of observation less than upper limit of a class called as the less than cumulative frequency, and the number of observation more than or equal to lower limit of a class called as the MCF. MCF. Okay, what does it mean? See, in previous example, LCF and MCF values are 2, 6, 13, 23, 39, 47, 50 and MCF 50, 48, 44, 37, 27, 11 and 3. Okay, less than cumulative frequency means number of observation less than upper limit of a class. This means that there are two observations less than upper limit of class. So upper limit of class is 20. So there are two observation less than upper limit of class, that is 20. Next, there are six observations which is less than upper limit of class, that is 30. There are 13 observation less than 40. There are 23 observation less than 50. Similarly, remaining one. Same as MCF. MCF is nothing but the number of observations more than or equal to lower limit of a class called as MCF. Okay. See an example. That means that there are 50 observation which is more than or equal to lower limit of class. So lower limit of first class is 10. There are 48 observation more than or equal to 20. Similarly, remaining one. This is the LCF and MCF. The next lecture we will see the frequency distribution and how to make the frequency distribution along with guidelines. Thank you.